Ahoy mates, Captain Marrow here, and recently I took a trip up to Williamsburg, Virginia. To start off my trip, first I went to the Governor's Palace of Governor Alexander Spotswood. A man who had a notorious dislike for pirates. So visiting was, you know, kind of fun. So the next stop was the Powder Magazine, built in 1715.
Today I'm here in Colonial Williamsburg, so let me step out of the way here. So directly behind me, over that way, that is the Powder Magazine. The Powder Magazine was built in 1715, although the idea was proposed in 1714 by Governor Alexander Spotswood. The idea for the Powder Magazine was proposed because, according to the governor, all the munitions and firearms and powder and everything laid about in a careless way and needed proper storage. So the Powder Magazine was built, and during the Golden Age of Piracy, the building would hold about 61,000 pounds of gunpowder. It's right here in the center of town. If there would have been a single spark, things would have gone terribly. So on to the next location.
In general, the town was very beautiful. After that, it was time to head for the old public jail, where Blackbeard's crew had been held. Also, sheep!
Ahoy mates, Captain Marrow here, and today I'm here at the public jail here in Williamsburg. So this building was originally made in 1704, and it was made to temporarily house prisoners. Blackbeard's crew would be held prisoner here until their executions. Conditions were just terrible, freezing cold. Most prisoners were kept in leg shackles. Those remaining of Blackbeard's crew that did not get acquitted, such as Samuel Odell and Israel Hands, they stayed in here for a little while, and then they were taken down the road that we can see right over there behind the fence. Which back in the day was called Gallows Road, but nowadays it's called Nicholson. So after going down Gallows Road, they would have been executed. It's said that they rode atop their respective coffins, and to this day there's still a ghost story, actually, about Gallows Road, about the Wagon of Death. So just as a whole, not really a place that you would ever want to spend any time in. I guess to be fair, most people that did spend their time here was against their will, so it makes sense. But yeah, this is the jail. And behind me is the Williamsburg Jail, where Blackbeard and his crew were held. And more importantly, for the sake of this video, right over here to the right of me is a road. So this road is called Nicholson at the moment, but that wasn't always the case. Back during the Golden Age of Piracy, this road would have been known as Gallows Road. So Gallows Road is where Blackbeard's crew rode to, you guessed it, the gallows. And it is also home to its own ghost story, specifically the Wagon of Death, which is in reference to Blackbeard's crew having ridden their wagons down to their execution point. So the Wagon of Death is supposed to be a ghostly wagon. No one has ever claimed to see it, but you can hear it. You can hear the creaking of the wheels, the clopping of the horse's feet, and anguished cries, only said to be heard at night. But not a whole lot else to that, just it's the Wagon of Death ghost story of Blackbeard's crew being taken to the gallows on a Gallows Road. All right.
After leaving downtown Colonial Williamsburg, the next stop was the College of William and Mary.
And I am at the College of William and Mary. The building was constructed in 1693, and it has a reputation for having been built with pirates' gold. So, in 1682, Buccaneers William Dampier, Edward Davis, and Lionel Wafer lived over in Jamestown, not too far from here. for about a year or so before heading off on their Pacific voyage. In 1683, a small boat appeared near Hampton with four pirates in it, one of which was Edward Davis, and he had a chest of gold and a chest of silvered items. His boat was seized, and the pirates were taken over. Apparently, it's Jackhammer Day here at the College of William and Mary, so that's fun. Over in England, the pirates were going to face trial, but Edward Davis came into contact with Reverend Blair, who he was able to broker a deal with. The pirate Edward Davis would gain his freedom, but only if he would contribute a substantial amount of his plundered gains down the Caribbean to the colony in Virginia. What he had to exchange for his freedom would be the rough equivalent of $1 million today, which from my understanding was about 1/4 of what he actually came back to Virginia with from his expedition out. So the $1 million that Edward Davis had to contribute for his freedom directly funded the College of William and Mary. So this is the Wren Building. This was constructed in 1693, and it has its reputation for being the college built with pirates' gold.
All in all, I had a great time, and it was a lot of fun being a pirate here in Colonial Williamsburg. A person not portraying an upstanding individual of the town, but instead a ruffian, a scoundrel of sorts. Everyone really enjoyed seeing it, so that was a lot of fun. But I'll definitely be back.